Hey, what's going on, guys? Figured I would bring you an update. I know a while ago I told you we were going to be setting up a 120-gallon reef tank. Kind of unfortunately lost interest in it, and then I got real busy. Ended up selling that tank to a buddy of mine, actually, that was interested in getting a fish tank. And we talked about saltwater and reef keeping and all that, and he ended up getting into the saltwater hobby. And that really lit a fire under my butt to set up a tank. So him and I have been kind of going through the process together, if you will. So I picked up a new tank. I didn't build this one. Had the canopy built by my dad. We'll kind of run through the tank right now, but excited to be back. Got the tank. It's been up and running now for probably 3 to 4 months, maybe. Got a bunch of corals in there. Just got the dosing set up, so things are a little bit messy right now. I just got done working on a couple of things, but let's take a look at it. Alright guys, so let's talk about what we got here. I picked up an Aqua Japan 150-gallon tank. It is 5 foot long, 24 inches deep, and 24 inches tall. Got a whole bunch of miscellaneous dry rock from one of the aquarium suppliers here. Cycled the tank for about a month and a half. Then added these clownfish. I forgot what they're called. They're like Wyoming something or another. Let the tank run with them in for a while, and then we had a local like club show or something come through, so I went there, picked up some coral, and when I picked up the first coral is kind of when it was game on. So anyways, I've been acquiring quite a few corals. You guys know me, I'm a stickhead. So I've been picking up a whole bunch of different acros, millies, monoporas. I got two species of green slimers. I got that one right there, which is was a lot smaller and had no encrusting on the base. Now you can see we got some encrusting on the base now. This guy here has been growing real quick. He was a lot smaller. That little nub on the bottom there starting to grow out. This one's really, really furry, so I like it. Got a bubble coral, you know, just things happening. Got the rainbow anemone. So I'm running with the ATI 4 foot 8 bulb fixture again. I swear by T5s. I did purchase this Reef Bright XHO fixture, and I don't like it. I just don't like it. Let's see, I got two MP10s on the tank. I'm running also two Jabo SW 20s, which are supposed to be like that AI clone pump. You know me, I'll use a Jabo pump. Down underneath the stand, I hate it. I hate this. I've always built my own stands and all my own stuff, so this kind of being just to a manufacturer spec kind of sucks. It's very tight, sucks to work in. But it is what it is. Sump came with the tank. It was all a package. It was a sump, tank, plumbing, and the stand. I'm using a Red Sea Reefer 300 protein skimmer. I don't know. I'm working with it. It does good, and then sometimes it kind of just freaks out and does its own thing. What I did with this tank is it came with technically two returns to the tank and one drain. So I made this this 3/4 inch one here a full siphon drain, and I am tuning that with a gate valve. And the big 1.5 inch is just the like the overflow of that and the emergency drain. And then I built a manifold. I'll go to the other side here. Built a manifold off of the return pump like I always do to run my reactors. I only got one reactor running on it right now. Might get something else running on there. I did have two reactors and I was running GFO, but I think it's way too early right now to be running GFO in the tank. So I just am running a bunch of carbon. Little fuge section. I've got a Jabo, I forget what the hell it is. SW something, I don't know. Got a little power head running in the refugium part. Also have a small power head running in the return section part, because this is where I am having my dosing pump add all the additives, so I just kind of want it to mix that all up. And a Jabo DC return pump. All the controllers I have mounted here except for the MP10s. Those are new additions, and these are used, old, they're beat up, they don't work right. So anyways, cheap. Just got a BRS order in and some coral orders, so I just got done dealing with all that. There's a closet right next to the tank, and I have taken over this as kind of my fish closet. This is the glass, or the plexi off of the light fixture. I'm not going to keep it on there. So anyways, I'm still working on cleaning this all up. I just kind of got everything put in here, that way it wasn't all over the garage, all over the living room. But I got testing, chemicals, additives. I got the dosing pump here. It's kind of like the dosing testing station. Extra equipment, and then I have the RO top off here. 10-gallon tank with a little pump, miscellaneous buckets, and then I just need to get these put in place. This little weatherproof box here is the dealio I'm using for the auto top off thing. It's just a transformer with a relay, and I spliced in an extension cord in here, that way it was only one plug instead of having 2 to 3 cords for the, I'll deal with that, for the auto top off. Anyways, dosing containers. Right now I'm only dosing the elk. I've been testing the levels here, and the calcium is actually pretty high. It's up at 500, but the alkalinity was at 6 the other day. So I have the dosing pump dosing slowly throughout every day right now to bring that alkalinity level up to 9.5 DKH, which is where I like it. Yeah, I'll try to keep it short. This is pretty much it. You know, let me know what you guys think, what you want to see. There is a, it's kind of crazy. Let me flip this around. It's kind of crazy. So there, lots changed on YouTube. There's a lot of people doing YouTube now, and they all make really good content. So I don't know where I fall anymore. I feel like I'm like the lost OG. I've been doing YouTube for a long, long, long time, and got out of the hobby for 5 years almost. And so yeah, I'm going through a YouTube now, and it's like, wow, there's a lot of people, and they do really good content. So I don't know where I'm gonna fall in that. If you guys want to see updates on it, I still love doing YouTube videos, so I'm gonna update on the tank every now and then. But I am by no means one of the guys that's gonna be able to fly all over the place, go to all the shows and all that stuff. It's just not what I'm able to do. So if you guys want to see it, let me know. Glad to be back, and I can't wait to give you guys some more updates on the tank. We'll see you in the next one. Later.